While this might look like spaghetti to you, it's a map of the pipelines that bring you everything from gasoline for your car to natural gas for cooking. Obviously, the pipeline inspection process is a big job.
We're looking out at public safety. Somebody once said that the essence of, trust itself is not the bind, but the bond. And we take that bond seriously. The public safety is what we're after. And we look after it as best we can.
How does PHMSA inspect approximately 2.6 million miles of pipeline? It's a three-part process for state and federal inspectors, including plant and construction inspections, on-site inspections, records inspections to ensure requirements have been met to maintain pipelines by the companies that work them.
Looking at the procedures and the records that those guys have to show that they have done that work. So that's the bulk of the inspection process.
Lane Miller runs PHMSA's Pipeline Training Center in Oklahoma City. The training ranges from dealing with liquefied natural gas to teaching inspectors exactly how difficult the welding process is.
We do a lot of construction inspections. So when that stuff's first going in the ground, we're out there to see every single piece. It's physically impossible for us just because of the fact of we have 3,000 operators as far as our pipeline company is all doing work at the same time. So our primary goal is safety and keeping the public safe. We don't go in and dig up all the pipelines and inspect every single foot of it.
So-called pigs play a role in the process.
This is called a smart pig. They use pigs in pipelines for various reasons, to clean the pipeline, to put between different liquids to separate them. Back in the day when they were made out of leather and barbed wire and things of this nature to clean the pipeline, it squealed when it went through the pipeline, made a screeching sound, and they called it a pig. But smart pigs are different. Smart pigs are sent into the pipeline and they have an ability to gather information and report it back to the operator on the condition of the pipeline.
You can see on this one where they put it together, this was an old acetylene weld. We talked about acetylene welding and you use the oxyacetylene out in the shop. You can see where it's not very uniform and it's not very even. And then when you come around here, it gets a lot wider and it's got some corrosion loss on it.
The whole objective is safety. But what about an actual accident? What is the response?
The process is set up such that when they detect a problem, they have to shut down their pipeline system. And then PHMSA becomes involved right away, and we may tell them they can't operate the pipeline until they do certain things. The incidence of leaks and spills on pipelines is not very great. Shipping product by pipeline is the safest way to transport any refined product or natural gas.
The overall mission of Office of Pipeline Safety is safety. And by confirming that the operators are doing this and that they're looking for problem areas, and when they find problem areas to fix it, it is safety.